Hello, this is about Remind. So you log in and it will put you to where your classes are. So I've got a couple classes joined. Here's where you create a class, give it a name, give it a code. Promise you only message older people. Anyway, it'll pop up like this. So this is my first period. I made the class code CAMS1. Class visibility, this class will appear in class search and on your profile, yes. And then I turned these off because I only want participants to message me and not each other. And I am a class owner. I can put another person in there as a class owner. Okay. Dot. All right. So if you go to the account settings and you go to notification preferences, here are all the ways that they can get in touch with me. So when I send a remind, it can come up in my email, or it can go to my phone, or it can go to this iPhone, or it can go to my desktop. Or it will just go straight into this program, which is what I'm counting on. All right. So back to profile, back here. Okay. So let's say I want to make a message. It's been a while since I've done this, and they've changed some stuff, but it looks really cool. All right. Like, here's the people in my class. Me and Jack. Jack's my guinea pig. I got my class settings here. Yeah, we already went through that. Messages. Okay. So this seems pretty cool. We got message here. All right. So this is going to my first period. I guess I can add other periods as I do it. So you type your message. Hello, all. And here is a very cool thing you can do. It's linked to your Google Drive and your Google Classroom. So if I want to send a Google Classroom assignment out to them, I can do that. Theoretically. Come on now. All right. So here my classes pop up. There's another one of my teacher demos. That's my modified class. Oh boy, it's got all my assignments in there. Okay, and there's my period 3. So I'm gonna put this one in. So they can follow this link to go to their classroom and they can get their assignment. So that's pretty cool. Couldn't do that before. You can upload a photo or a video or just upload a file. So if you wanted to push something out to them, like, let's get a PDF. Here's an assessment. So apparently that's on there. I hope so. Yay. So click on there and it comes up. Oh, not that. But it's going to come. Oh, the PDF comes down here. Sorry. So this is something that I was using to get questions for Maria's when we were doing the unit tests. Okay. This, you can do upload a file. Okay. Well, let's try Google Drive. How about that? Let me show you my podcast review form. So that has popped up there as well. So, hey, you can put more than one thing on there, and then you can schedule it to come out whenever you want, or you can send it right away. Bing. Okay, so what I would probably do with this, well, I'm thinking of using this is, to send a question to them. What was the biggest difference between the North and the South in 1840? Something that has to do. Something that's spelled correctly and something that has to do with what we're trying to learn that day. So I would send this out and I would have the kids send me responses to this. So they would send responses and then I'd be able to track them on here. So the conversations would pop up. Here's what I sent to Jack. And you can just tell if they send you an answer back, it's going to have message on there. So, yeah. So in a nutshell, that's what Remind can do for you. If you have any questions, please ask.